Hello, today we shall see Introduction to Kumbh and let us see the influence of kumbhing on yarn characteristics. So the kumbhing process is included in the spinning process line for kumbhing of medium to fine yarns with an aim to exert a positive influence on the yarn characteristics. And for details of the processing line, you may please refer to lecture 26, which is Objects of Kumbh Preparatory. The most important yarn properties that kumbhing influences are evenness, strength, and cleanliness. There is an improvement in fiber parallelization also, but this may not always be an advantage since it reduces fiber cohesion and results in sliver breaks and introduction of false drafts. So although there is an improvement in these three properties and along with that fiber parallelization, the fourth might not be always an advantage from the point of view of breakages and introduction of false draft. There are some fiber properties also that kumbhing influences, and a few of them are: first one is smoothness, visual appearance, as well as handle. So kumbhing also improves certain yarn properties by reducing the need to insert more twist in the yarn. So we can always find that combed cotton yarn requires less twist than a carded yarn. Such low twist yarns perform well at knitting, which is an added advantage for any downstream process. So let us see the operations of the comber. The comber must perform the following operations to bring about an improvement. So whatever improvement we've seen in yarn or fabric, so to bring about those improvements, what are the steps or what are the functions that the kumbhar needs to perform? First thing it needs to do is eliminate a predetermined amount of short fibers. Then it must also eliminate impurities, if at all they have been able to reach to the stage of kumbhar, which should normally not happen. Then it should also eliminate neps. Although we can say here that complete elimination of neps is not really possible. Kumbhar should also give a good quality sliver. So out of these four functions, removal of short fibers is the most important one. All the above operations involve a cost due to the additional expenditure on the machine, as well as the floor space, the people that are working on the machine, as well as loss of raw material through noil. So all these factors, because we are introducing three machines, two for kumbhar preparatory and one for kumbhar, we would be incurring that amount of extra amount of cost here, along with floor space and the people or the personnel that is required to run those machines, along with the extra cost that is incurred on the raw material that is removed in the form of noil. So there is an added cost due to the design of the kumbhar machine itself. How this is involved, let us see a little bit in detail. Modern kumbhars run at a cylinder speed of around 500 rpm, which means that the kumbhar completes 500 cycles in one particular minute. And in this 1 minute, the heavy nipper assembly has to move to and fro. So how many times it has to move, let us see, has to be accelerated to a maximum speed and slowed down to about 8 times per second. So this is quite a high speed, and it would also incur some amount of additional cost. So when you overall look at the costs that are involved, there is an approximate increase in cost by around 25 rupees per kg of yarn. This too, it will depend on the quantity of noil or waste that has been extracted at kumbhar. If it is more, then this cost would further rise. Noil proportion. The amount of noil combed out varies between 8% to 25%. Now, depending on the upgradation or the noil removal that is required, or the improvement in properties that are needed, depending on that, the kumbhing operation or the amount of noil that is removed has been classified into various types. So there are three types of kumbhing classified on the basis of noil removed and the corresponding improvement in quality. The first one would, you can just say it is upgrading or semi-kumbhing, with an oil percentage which is below 12. Normally combed sliver is done with an oil percentage between 12 to 18%. Highly combed would be 18 to 22%, and a super combed, which is rarely done, and it is only done for super fine yarns, and this would percentage would be about 22. So if you really practically see, there are only three types. The fourth one is a super comb, where the oil percentage would be very, very high, which is about 22%. So this is a graph which is just for understanding, shown for different Bayer sorter diagrams for cotton, which is there before combing. If you see this and you compare it with the cotton after combing, we see that the amount of short fibers have reduced drastically, but still you would find some amount of short fibers in the sliver that we have tested for Bayer sorter diagram after combing. Then we also look at the noil, and if you take a Bayer sorter for the noil that is being collected, then we would find that there are some long fibers which were not supposed to be in the noil have come in the noil. So this would be a normal scenario for combed sliver and the noil if you take a Bayer sorter diagram. The effect of increase in noil is on the shown on the x-axis in the graph that will just come up. The effect of increase in noil is shown on the important yarn properties like strength, evenness and imperfections. So this is the graph which shows the relation between the two. On the x-axis, we see the noil percentage, which goes on increasing up to 20%. And on the y-axis, the improvement in the yarn properties is shown with relation to strength, evenness, and imperfections. The line that is shown as A over here, that shows the yarn strength. B shows the evenness, and C shows the imperfections. So following are some observations from this particular graph, and this graph was a part of the work presented by Mr. Frey of Ritter Machine Works in Germany. So from the adjoining graph, it is observed that the strength and the evenness improve, but not as much as expected. A greater improvement is observed in the case of imperfections. We can see a drastic improvement is there. There is a great improvement up to 10% level of noil extraction. So up to 10% you see a drastic improvement in the imperfections. But after 10, the improvement slightly reduces. Beyond 10%, the improvement is observed in the ends down rate in the downstream processes. So beyond 10, if you increase the noil percentage, it is not much observed either in strength or evenness improvement or even in imperfection improvement. But what is observed is that in the downstream processes, like after spinning, if you see the warping, the performance of the yarn at warping or weaving, it improves even after the 10% levels. The ends rate, ends down rate is lower in case of combed yarn as compared to carded yarn. This is what has been observed in the downstream processes. After 20% level, there is not much improvement, and actually the ends down rate start to increase again after this level. So after 20% of noil removal level, it is not really useful to increase beyond this particular level, because it doesn't show any kind of improvement even in the downstream processes in way of reduction in ends down rate. So the highest level would be around 20%. So let us see how to calculate a noil. Calculation of noil can be done by this particular formula which is given here. We can take the weight of noil divided by weight of noil plus weight of sliver multiplied by 100, or weight of noil divided by weight of the lap that is fed multiplied by 100. So let us solve some few problems on this particular formula, based on this particular formula. So the first problem is, if the sliver delivered weighs 360 grains and the noil is 40 grains, find the noil percentage on comber. So directly using the first formula, we see that it is, and both are given in the same unit. So 40 divided by 40 grains per the sliver weight multiplied by 100 gives you 10%. Coming to the second numerical problem, it is said that in a certain test, lab cotton fed was as follows. So now here fed data has been given, and these are the respective kgs that are being fed on 6 heads, and the corresponding oil that is extracted is also given, and it is given in grams on the 6 heads of the comber. Find the oil percentage on each head and the range. So we can use the second formula which was earlier discussed. Only thing that you one needs to take care is that this is the oil is given in grams, whereas the lab weight is given in kgs. So one needs to convert these grams to kgs. So first step I would do is divide 160 by 1000, and then divided by the lab weight in kgs, multiply by 100, I would get the oil percentage. This was for head number one. Similarly, one can calculate using these values the oil percentage on all the other heads. And for range, we need to take the highest value of oil and the lowest value, which is 10.67, and the lowest is 10.13, and the difference would be 0.54 percentage range. So we come to the third problem on this particular oil. In a short test, a sliver collected weighs 600 grams, and oil collected on the 8 head comber was these particular values given here. Find the total oil and the range percentage. So when total oil has been asked, so we can just add up all the oils on the, all the heads, 8 heads, and we get the answer as 78 grams. And to calculate the oil percentage, it is oil divided by the sliver plus oil in the denominator multiplied by 100, so we get 11.5% oil. And the range would be the highest oil that is collected minus the lowest oil, that is 10.5 minus 9, divided by the sliver that would be collected on one single head, because this was the total sliver and oil that was being fed on 8 heads. So we get on a single head by dividing by 8, and then we multiply by 100, and we get a range for the oils on six oil percentage on the 8 heads. So now let us come to the next topic. Let us see the effect of oil on the draft values. So calculation of draft using the machine data, as we know, is that is calculating from the surface fields, is known as a mechanical draft. Calculation of draft using the output and the input material data is known as the actual draft. So normally on any particular machine where the machine does not eliminate trash or oil, or even does not insert twist, in such machines the actual draft and the mechanical drafts would be equal. But in case of machines like comber, which is unlike a draw frame where mechanical and actual draft was equal, in the case of comber, the machine eliminates oil, and therefore the actual draft value shall be more than mechanical draft value. The relation between actual draft and mechanical draft would be as follows. Actual draft is going to be more. So the formula would be mechanical draft into 100 upon 100 minus oil. So based on this particular formula, let us try and see some numericals. So the first one is find the actual draft if the mechanical draft is 53.03 and an oil is 10%. So this is a direct use of the formula. Actual draft would be mechanical draft into 100 upon 100 minus 10, which is an oil. So actual draft would be 58.92. One thing to be observed here, this value is more than the mechanical draft as expected, since on comber, actual draft is more than mechanical draft. Coming to the next problem, if the hank of the lab fed to the comber is 0.012, find the hank of the sliver when 6 such slivers are combined and the oil is 10%. Mechanical draft is given. So in this particular problem, you have been given data about the input and output material, and you have been given mechanical draft. So what we need to do as a first step is calculate the actual draft using the oil percentage which we have been given. So actual draft value comes out to be 66.66, which again, just to confirm, see that it is more than mechanical draft since this is a comber. So now actual draft is equal to hank delivered upon hank fed into number of doublings. So put substituting the actual draft values here, and we need to find out hank delivered multiplied by number of doublings is given as 6, and we have been given hank fed. So substituting, we get hank delivered as 0.13. Coming to the next problem, a comber delivers 60 grains per yard of sliver on an 8 head comber. Total mechanical draft is 60 and noil is 12. Find the weight per yard of lap fed. Again, we have been given data about the material, and we have been given mechanical draft and noil. So just like before, our first step would be to find out actual draft using the formula, and we get the value as 68.18, which is more than 60. Actual draft, there's one more formula which can be used, that is weight per yard fed divided by weight per yard delivered multiplied by number of doublings. So just by substituting these values here, since doubling is 8, on the 8 head comber is said over here, so doublings would be 8. And the delivered weight per yard is given as 60 grains per yard. Once we substitute, we get fed lap grains per yard as 511.36 grains per yard. Coming to the next problem, the linear density of a lap on comber of 6 head is 70 kilotex, and 20% waste is extracted. If the comber delivers 7 kilotex sliver, find the mechanical draft. So here again we have been given data about the material. So first step would be to calculate the actual draft here, which is ktex fed upon ktex delivered multiplied by number of doublings, and we got the actual draft as 60. And now we have been asked to find out the mechanical draft. Since we have been given noil, we can easily do that, and we find that the mechanical draft comes out to be 48, which is now less than the actual draft that we have calculated. So coming to the next problem, the lap fed to a 6 head comber is 56 kilotex, and a sliver of 7 kilotex is needed to be produced. If the noil extracted is 10% and draft constant is 1500, calculate the CP needed or required. So again, from the given data, we can find out the actual draft. 56 divided by 7 into number of doublings, which is 48. Mechanical draft we can calculate by, since we have been given the noil percentage, from actual draft we calculate the mechanical draft, whose value, which we see, is 43.2, which is less than actual draft. And so from this mechanical draft that is given, by using the formula CP is equal to draft constant upon draft, we can find the CP value. It comes to be 34.72, which could be rounded off to 35 teeth. So with this, we come to the next numerical. The sliver delivered by the comber is 5 kilotex and CP is 40. If the linear density of the sliver is changed to 6 kilotex, calculate the new CP. So first of all, we should know that draft constant is same on the machine throughout, whatever the situation. So looking at the left-hand side, this is the existing draft constant values here. So draft constant is draft multiplied by CP. So kilotex fed upon kilotex delivered, which is existing, multiplied by number of doublings into existing CP would give me a draft constant. But this will also be equal to the new conditions, that is kilotex fed multiplied by number of doublings divided by new kilotex delivered multiplied by new CP. Since this draft constant is going to be equal, we can equate these two equations. And since kilotex fed and the number of doublings and all are constant in the above situation which is given over here, we get a new equation here. Existing CP divided by kilotex delivered is equal to new CP divided by new kilotex delivered. Now simply by substituting the values here, we get the new CP value as 48 teeth. So to get a sliver of linear density 6 kilotex, we need to change the CP from 40 teeth to 48 teeth. So with this, we come to the end of today's lecture. Thank you.